Hello there, amazing and wonderful people of YouTube. So it's about 11 a.m. here in Denmark. So, and I just got up. Don't hate me. It's the lockdown thing, virus thing. So I can sleep late. I'm in Ice VM again. I kind of like messing around with Ice VM at the moment. And apparently some of you guys like Ice VM also. So I kind of want to show you guys some panel alternatives to this stock panel we have down here. I just installed OpenSUSE Tumbleweed again. I keep coming back to it. I don't know why. I have this love-hate relationship with it. And I always install that with KDE because in my world, OpenSUSE or SUSE have always been a KDE distribution. So I was like, let's try IceVM in OpenSUSE. So that's what we have here. What you see over here is blank. If I open something here, let's just say I open Arc. It pops up here, so it functions as a blank. The reasons why I put them here and up here and this tint 2 up on top is basically because we have a bar down here. You could put them down, you know, where you want. So I will talk a little bit about why I think you should use one of these things or both of them or whatever. Oh, my VirtualBox machines thingy just came up. And let's go into blank. Blank is, a lot of you guys know blank. And if you want to configure it, the best way is just to hold down control and right click. And then you go into preferences. So you can basically customize it. Don't yell at me for the theming being all over the place. This is a fresh install of IceVM. I haven't themed it at all. But you know, hey, you can zoom it and you can make it really, really amazeballs and whatnot. You can like behavior, auto hide it. I think you need to do this to auto hide it. Yep. You can get different docklets. I don't know if there is a menu bar for Plank yet. I don't think there is. Or if there is, I have not found it yet. Or it's a really, really old project. So that's the one drawback from it. But let's just say you don't want to use Pacman FM or Vox File Manager or iDesk to control icons on your desktop. You're kind of thinking a little bit in the way of Elementary OS and other like stock GNOME where they don't allow desktop icons. This could be a great alternative. This is actually what Elementary OS is using. Elementary OS is using Plank. That's simple. They're just theming it their way. I have something in my eye. Don't touch your face if you've been outside. And I have not been outside, so I can touch everything on my body right now. And I like to touch my body. And don't get any funny ideas here, guys, girls. But yeah, Plank. Use that. It's a pretty alternative. And it's kind of spice up the desktop a little bit, if you get my idea. So you could use Plank while you have the normal taskbar down here. Oh, I hate when that comes up. Then we have Tint 2. A lot of people love Tint 2, especially OpenBox people and all that. And if you go over to Meyer Linux website, or not website, YouTube channel, he has a lot of, he used Tint 2 a lot for his OpenBox versions and all that. So he can talk to you guys about theming it and all that. I kind of wish he will make, so Dan, if you're watching this, please make a Tint 2 video where you customize it, set it up, do whatever you want with it, or do what you do to make it look the way you do and feel the way you do. Because Tint is really, really, really versatile. And this is like, it comes with this settings manager here, and you can install themes and what have you not. And you can see here, there's a lot of customization here. This is just the stock standard Tint layout. You can make it look amazeballs. I'm not even joking. Really, really make it look amazeballs. There's some amazing themes out there for Tint 2. And I also think you can get a menu for it if you go into items here. Elements available, elements selected, executor, separator, free space, launch, a taskbar, system tray, clock. You know, and I think you can get more of these also. But I highly recommend that you go over and pester Meyer Linux to make a video about this, because he is kind of like, in my opinion, the go-to guy for Tint videos. Or sorry, Tint expertise. So go over to his videos. Just search for Meyer Linux if you do it in here. You can see here, this is his channel. Just go over here and then maybe down here on his newest IceVM videos and say to him like, hey, can you show us how Tint 2 works and make a video about Tint 2 and how to theme it and set it up and all that? Because I'm sure he can do that way better than I can do, because he has more experience in it. If I'm not mistaken, he's using 10.2 for his open box sessions down here, his open box videos. So he has way more time spent in 10.2 and stuff like that. I know about Plank, I know about AWVN that's not used anymore, and I know about, you know, the stock XFCE panels, the KDE panels, and, you know, this panel down here. I don't rarely use any alternative panels other than Plank, because I don't really use these kind of tools anymore. And I am thinking about trying to take this away. You can take this away in a bash script, or not in a bash script, but via the configuration file for IceVM. It's really, really easy. You put in a 0 instead of a 1. Just Google how to remove the taskbar or the panel bar in IceVM, and you get it right away. It's useless for me to show you guys that. And also, you can see I have like transparency here. You don't get that out of the box. So I kind of just opened these programs. I have not put them into my startup file or anything like that. I just opened them via terminal because I'm not sticking with this. So I just opened Plank here in a terminal. I just type in Plank and then Plank came up. I typed in 10.2 and 10.2 came up. You get my idea here? And then you need a compositor manager like Compton or something like that. I just installed Compton and then open Compton in a terminal window, and then I get transparency. It will also give you, if you configure it, if you shadows, and you can, if you move it, you can make it transparent and all that stuff. Maybe I should make a video about Compton at some point. But it's just to show you guys that you can make like a simple, some would say ugly, Windows manager look great. Like if you want to see what you can do with IceVM, absolutely Linux, there you go. And we have the guys in here have a lot of great tools for it. It is a little bit of a dormant process, or well, they made a version last year. But if you go in here and you screenshots, this is IceVM, and they're using the ROX file manager here. And they have their own tools also. But this is not a bad look. Like, it is outdated. Like, it has this 90s look to it. But I will not call it ugly. And you can make it way, way, way more better looking. Let's go, just go into IceVM. IceVM look. I think these are all IceVM environments. The reason why I make these videos about IceVM is because I think it's a little bit overlooked. And it is by far one of the simplest and most actively developed Windows managers out there at the moment. Like I said in other videos, I think they get updates like every month or every second month or something like that. It's amazeballs. So you can make this look amazeballs. And if you go over to Tinker for Fun and Automation, again, I need to put his link down below if I remember it. He's starting to go into IceVM really, really heavily. So he can also help you. He's actually using IceVM as a tiling Windows manager. It's actually really, really interesting. He's merging other stuff into IceVM that makes it a really, really amazing desktop environment. Just the fact that I have Plank over here, it spices up this whole desktop a little bit. And let's say if I find like a menu plugin for 10.2 and all that, or for Plank in that matter, you don't really need this, in my opinion, a little bit outdated, ugly looking taskbar down here. And then you're just using, you know, IceVM as the background for your desktop, meaning, you know, it handles Windows and all that stuff, theming, and if you want icon, you can install iDesk, or you can use Pac-Man, either FM or QT, or Pac-Man FM, QT, or GTK to do that. But go and experiment with this, because you can make all these Windows managers look really, really nice and really, really modern by putting in modern technology and modern ideas. I'm out of here. See you all later. Bye-bye.